In early March, Diana Barrett was one of New York's first COVID-19 cases.
Hi everyone, this is day 8 of my Corona journal.
Through daily posts, she shared her journey and what she learned about the virus.
It's gonna be a longer recovery than I had anticipated.
But months later, her journey hasn't ended.
The frightening thing is what we are seeing is that people are not recovering.
And she's not alone.
There's a lot of people that don't want to believe this is true. But, you know, this is one of those things that's true whether or not you want to believe it or not.
Dr. Daniel Griffin is the chief of infectious diseases at ProHealth New York and has treated more than 1,000 COVID-19 patients.
In about May, when you started to see people say, I'm really not getting better. You know, a few weeks, and we said, you know, that's fine. You were really sick. Give it some time. But then people started saying, it's been some time. It's been a month. It's been 2 months. It's been 3 months.
Symptoms include everything from loss of taste and smell, hair falling out, and more serious issues, including lung and heart damage.
And I worry about the people that have the heart damage, you know, who are having trouble going up a flight of stairs. So what will be the long-term thing? Can those lungs ever heal, or is this permanent?
A CDC study revealed 35% of people who test positive for COVID-19 and have symptoms aren't better after 2 or 3 weeks, and even after they've stopped testing positive, they call themselves long haulers.
But now as we're looking at it, we're realizing a lot of patients have a long haul, that COVID is not just like the flu. It's not just a few days and then a few percent of people feel crummy.
But there are only theories as to why it happens.
The simple answer that, you know, physicians never like to go with, but is the truth, is we don't know. We're learning.
Barrett has continued to see specialists and deals with new medical problems from the virus, including issues with vision and reoccurring headaches.
Let me tell you, this is not a matter of having the flu or ending up on a ventilator. There is an extraordinarily large bucket in the middle that you do not want to end up in.
The true total number of long haulers, like much of the virus, remains unknown.
That's really important to remember. As a country, we are tracking infections, we are tracking hospitalization, and we are tracking mortality. But 95% of people, if not more, are left to recover at home like I did with Gatorade and Tylenol.
In the coming days, we'll introduce you to more people.
My hair has shed quite a bit.
Doubted by doctors, unaware of the virus's long-term impact.
He told me I needed a psychiatrist, that most of this is in my head.
Some not believed even by friends and family.
I became suicidal at that point.
We'll share the journey of doctors to learn why long hauling happens and how survivors struggle to recover and be recognized.
We probably have more people still suffering from COVID, unable to return to work, unable to return to their daily life the way they used to be, than people died of COVID.
In Fort Worth, I'm William Joy.